The best way to maximize cost optimization for Google Kubernetes Engine is to make sure your app and GKE are configured for each other. Today, we'll talk about some tips and best practices for configuring GKE to work with your app, and we'll wrap up our cost optimization journey. Let's go beyond your GKE bill. The last video went over some tips for configuring your app, and the videos before that covered a lot of best practices. If you haven't seen the previous videos, make sure to watch them before you watch this one. I'll start with some suggestions for batch and serving workloads. Then we'll do some networking and finally wrap up the whole video series and talk about what's next. As always, knowledge about your application can help you focus on which cost optimization techniques will give you the most impact. We can simplify most applications by grouping them into two groups, batch and serving. Batch applications have work to do, but tend to be less concerned about startup time and usually aren't time sensitive overall. Apps like monthly data calculations or low priority data transformation are great examples of batch jobs. As these jobs need to be scheduled, the cluster autoscaler can spin up new nodes and then remove them when the job is done. Even better, node auto-provisioning works best with batch workloads, since it can figure out optimal resources and then create a new node pool, and doesn't need to worry as much about spikes in demand. Here are some other tips for working with batch workloads. The cluster autoscaler can delete empty nodes faster when it doesn't need to also restart the pods on those nodes. Splitting up your applications into dedicated node pools using labels and selectors or taints and tolerations can help the cluster autoscaler scale quicker and avoid wasted resources. There's even an optimized utilization profile for the cluster autoscaler that focuses more on maximizing utilization rather than keeping spare resources at the ready. It scales down a lot quicker, which can help aggressively minimize extra resources. Also, you can separate different applications with node auto-provisioning along with using taints and tolerations. Node pools will then be better sized for each application, once again, optimizing your resource usage. And don't forget that preemptible VMs are much cheaper to use, but only if your apps are fault tolerant and much less time sensitive. Opposite of batch applications are serving apps, which need the ability to scale rapidly in response to spikes in demand. For example, a retail website on major shopping holidays. In order to handle the sudden increases in demand, it's good for serving workloads to be lean and optimized to work best with GKE. The quicker that pods can start up, the more efficient autoscalers are at responding to demand. If you have a serving app that requires resources with a long provisioning time, like GPUs, it makes sense to over-provision and have resources at the ready before the demand spikes. Plus, you can use pause pods to help you scale ahead. We went over some ways to over-provision and to keep your apps lean in the previous videos. Optimizing both of those will give you the most cost-efficient way to handle high demand spikes. Here's another best practice for GKE. Make sure to use NodeLocal DNS caching. If you're running a version with kubeDNS, apps that make a lot of DNS lookups will put extra pressure on it. While the kubeDNS autoscaler will create more kubeDNS replicas, it takes time to add those replicas and increases resource usage. Instead of just increasing the kubeDNS replicas in your configuration, add the NodeLocal DNS cache add-on. Each node will then store a DNS cache, which helps kubeDNS require less resources and saves overall time for lookups. On top of that, round-trip request time is usually better when it's low. One tip for lowering this is to use container-native load balancing. Rather than sending requests to instance groups and then pods, container-native load balancing allows requests to go directly to the pod by creating what's called a network endpoint group. When these are configured, GKE Ingress will handle the creation of the L7 load balancer, along with forwarding rules, health checks, firewalls, and more. One quick tip for you. If you do container-native load balancing, you'll want to start failing your readiness probe as soon as you receive a SIG term, which we talked a little bit about in the last video. That way, the load balancers will know to stop forwarding new requests to your app. Not only does container-native load balancing provide improved load balancing and more efficient autoscaling, it can also enable you to use other tools like Traffic Director and other Google Cloud services. All right, I know this was a ton of information to absorb. You can always reference these videos and the full best practices guide, which will be kept up to date as new versions and tips are available. Plus, those tips lead right to the documentation for steps on how to implement them. Let's do a quick summary and checklist. Start with the culture and move the cost discussion to the left. Help teams understand how their work affects cost, even if you've built an abstraction layer between teams and their clusters. try creating programs like online classes to help raise familiarity and create cost optimization awareness. Use monitoring to better understand how applications use resources, and then implement quotas, requests, and limits that make sense for your apps while also minimizing any wasted costs. From machine families to preemptibles, you can optimize your infrastructure to improve performance and save money. Don't forget about committed use discounts, too. The cloud's dynamic resources help make autoscaling an efficient strategy, but configuring it correctly for your applications is vital to handling spikes in demand while also balancing performance with cost. Make sure that you spend time to increase your application's compatibility with Kubernetes and configuring GKE for your application for the best results. Cost optimization is all about increasing the business value for what you get out of what you're spending on the cloud. Saving costs can be a part of that, but these tips are more about getting the most return out of costs and optimizing your usage. We've covered a wide range of things to consider when building, scaling, and deploying on GKE. Make sure to check out the full best practices guide for more details, and thank you for watching.